In a recent interview, NBA star Andre Iguodala recommended that I get a chain that says BT on it, standing for big time, because in his opinion, I always big time the players, wanting to talk about Kobe first and then about everyone else. Well, here in Los Angeles, Vic the Brick Jacobs is a sports icon. He's known among all the members of the media as the biggest Kobe supporter.
Let me ask you this, do people ever hate on you because you like Kobe? Do you ever get comments like, why do you always talk about Kobe, Kobe, Kobe?
You know, I have been a Kobe Bryant fan since he set foot in Philadelphia, from Philadelphia when he was 17 years old, playing at the Pyramid in Long Beach, summer ball, 17 years old, and I went to his hotel room, he was eating French fries, and I said, you know, Kobe, you are the fresh poet. You are the new poet of Los Angeles, and I could feel this vibe in the room. He's munching French fries. He's offering me fries. I'm saying, Kobe, we are just exhilarated that you are here. And Jerry West knew that this guy was an incredibly special ball player and a special person.
Andre Iguodala was making fun of me that I ask everybody about Kobe. He said, why do you ask first about Kobe, then about everybody else? What would you answer him?
Because he is a supreme baller on the planet. Kobe Bryant, right now, you can have your King James, you can have your Bron, you can have your CP3, you can have your Dwayne Wade. It's all about Kobe Bryant. Just look at the Olympic squad. They all came to Kobe for advice, took their cue from Kobe Bryant, how to play ball, how to recapture the gold for America. They didn't look to King James. They looked to Kobe Bryant for leadership and courage, the Corazon y Pasión.
Vic the Brick Jacobs, are you kidding me?
What can you tell me about Vic?
What I have to say about Vic?
Yeah.
Oh man, he brings the passion, the energy, the corazon.
You are deluded.
No.
I love that about you.
Is there anyone like him on the radio in the world? Not in America, in the world.
In the world, no, brother. Come on. I love working with the guy.
What can you tell me? Like, what are his three slogans you could drop?
You're delirious.
I'm delirious.
He's delirious
one of them.
Now.
You're feeling you.
Feeling you, Viva.
Feeling everybody. Yeah. Feeling Laker fans.
Yeah.
Oh, another one. El Muñaco.
El Muñaco.
Manny's back.
Damn right, Manny's
and
back.
And it's all what he predicted.
That's right. This guy right here, he was calling it before anybody else.
How about
Be the bamboo.
Bamboo.
We bend, we do not break.
Barack
exactly.
Obama quoted him this week. I don't know if you heard that.
You're kidding. Nah.
You didn't see that?
No. Nah. You know, now he's taking my lines, Obama.
Yeah.
Now he's taking my, he picked North Carolina. He's giddy. The man is giddy.
Obama gave a speech. He was talking to the nation. Reporters went after him and he said, I will bend but will not break.
He is the bamboo.
He Barack is the bamboo.
Now Barack's the bamboo.
Barack's always been the bamboo. Well,
then the government's in good hands.
The great hands.
All jokes aside about Obama stealing Vic the Brick's lines, I have to tell you in all seriousness that more and more Obama supporters are coming up to me and telling me that every day that this economic crisis is getting worse and worse, John McCain looks better and better, and that Obama is not handling this economic crisis right. Now, I don't know if he is or isn't, all I know that we are in a very tough situation, and many people are losing their jobs. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.